Today's video is about how you can get your Shopify products listed for free on Google Shopping. Hi, I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI doctor who helps e-commerce store to get their products on Google so you get more sales. Since last year, Google has made it free for any e-commerce store to list their products on Google for free, whether it is on Google Search or Google Shopping tab. Google wants to be competitive and want to make sure that Amazon is not getting the lion's share of the e-commerce market. One, you have to sign up for a Google Ads account. Two, you also need to sign up for a Google Merchant Center account. If you Google retail for Google, you will be able to find that. For anyone who wants to run a Google Ad, you need to sign up for a Google Ads account. Even if your products are listed for free on a Google Shopping tab, you still need to sign up for a Google Ads account because it's all part of the sign up process. However, when you set it up, there is no need to give them your credit card number and they won't be deducting any money from you. Basically, it's just setting up as a connector so that Google will be able to pull your product information to show it on the shopping tab. Keep in mind that you need to use the same email account to sign up for your Google Ads account, your Merchant Center account, as well as the login for your Shopify account. If you can, as much as possible, stick to this one email address because then it's easier for the product information to sync across all the three platforms. Once you have set up your Merchant Center account, fill up your business information, shipping information, customer service information, sales tax information, everything is set up properly, then you want to link your Google Ads account with your Merchant Center account. If you go to your Google Ads account under settings, under linked accounts, this is what you're going to see if you have linked them all up. This is the tab where you can see them linked together. And then next, you go back to your Google Merchant Center account. And under settings as well, under linked accounts, you're going to see two different setups. One setup that shows that you are connected to the Shopify store, and the other setup is to show that your Merchant Center account is connected to your Google Ads account. Both needs to be linked, and you'll be able to see the linked connection on this particular interface. The screenshot I'm sharing right here shows how it looks like when Merchant Center is linked to the Google Ads successfully. As well as if you go to this part where you connect to your Shopify store, you click on the link, this will lead you back to your Shopify store where you will be installing an app for your Shopify store called Google. And then you go on to this overview and the setup. Under the settings, you fill up this required information, you link it to your Google Ads account. You'll be able to see the Google Ads account ID here if it's linked. And then you also need to link to your Merchant Center account to say everything's linked successfully and you agree to their terms of agreement. And then you'll be able to see that you have completed this information on the overview, and you'll be able to see the number of products over here, this particular screenshot. If it's successful, you can see that you will all be approved eventually. This is how it's going to look like. Otherwise, it's going to be in a disapproved state till further notice. Once you have filled up all this information, then you need to wait for 3 to 5 working days for Google to review your Merchant Center account information or the information you have filled up, as well as your product information. If you have problems getting your Google account approved, there could be a number of reasons that you haven't filled up your business information correctly. Check out my other video here where I talk about the top 3 reasons why your account is suspended. I'm also going to put the link down in the description below. Check that out for more information. The next thing you want to make sure is you have all your product information. So there are a number of attributes that Google needs you to fill in to fulfill their eligibility requirements. You need to be aware of that there are actually 2 types of Google listings. One is the, which I call it the basic listings to show it on Google Search and Google Image Search, and enhanced listings, that's the precise word that Google use, Google Enhanced Listings, which allows your products to be listed on the Google Shopping tab. For free Google listings, that is to get your products listed just on search itself and image search, there is a list of attributes that you need to make sure is fulfilled, like the title, your description, pricing. There's basic information that you need to put in there. So once you have that, you'll be easily approved. To be eligible for enhanced listings, you need a longer list of attributes to be provided to Google. I'm going to put the link to the resource down in the description. There's a list of attributes depending on which industry your store is in. You might need to fill in more information or lesser information, so you need to check that out. I'm not going to go into the details of the list of attributes that you need to put in. This is something that I'll do in a future video, so don't forget to hit subscribe for more of such videos about how to get your products listed for free. Once you have that listed up and all your products are synced together, basically Google Merchant Center is going to receive a data feed, which is like a stream of product information. So if you have all your details listed correctly and they're all in the correct format, that's how Google would like it to be, then you are fine. If there is any modifications that you need, maybe you are not using the right correct formatting, maybe you are using all caps which you need to modify, then you might either need to modify your product information directly from your Shopify store, or alternatively, if you just want Google to accept the correct version of how your product information should look like, you can actually go to Google Merchant Center and check out the product feed. You can modify the information right here. I'm going to share a screenshot here as well, where you over here you can see exactly this is where and how you can modify this piece of information on Merchant Center. So you are giving Google the correct set of information. So once you have everything set up, then you're basically good to go after everything is approved. If your account is approved, but if your products are not approved for enhanced listings on the Google Shopping tab itself, you might need to go back to modify some of those attributes. You might have some attributes that are missing, or you didn't put it in the correct format, so you need to go back and diagnose it. You can diagnose these issues right here in the Diagnostics tab. You can see right here, I'm going to put the screenshot right here for you to see if there are any product issues. This is where you can click on here to see the list of issues, or to see which of the products that are not approved and what are the possible issues. But if it's an account issue, you basically will be able to see it right here, account issues. It'll be shown over here, and then they will tell you that your account is suspended. So you might need to make further changes with that. I hope you find this video really useful. It might sound a little bit complex, but it's just a lot of information that you need to put together. You need to connect your three accounts, your Shopify store, connect to Google Merchant Center, connect to your Google Ads, and vice versa in a reverse direction. Once you have that set up, you have all your product information listed correctly, business information listed correctly, and you are good to go. This is an exceptional opportunity for your products to be listed on Google, the number one search engine where people go to research for when they want to buy a new product. So if you have an e-commerce store, Shopify store, don't forget to tap into this opportunity. If you enjoy this video and find it really useful, do hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. Turn it on so you don't miss any of my future videos. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.